Let me actually deconstruct how I did this project. As you can see here, I have one main piece of footage in the timeline that was just me pretending to tap a hammer against the camera screen. Each time my hammer made contact with that screen, I just added a glass tapping effect, so it made it sound like I was actually tapping glass, but I was just swinging my hammer towards my camera about a foot away. During the second tap up here, I just added a free asset that I found at productioncrate.com that made it look like the glass had actually cracked. I'll leave a link to that down below in the description. I also added the sound of glass breaking along with that, and I just timed it for when my hammer seemed to make contact at what would be the screen. But the real fun part about this was to get the glass to shatter and have my entire image blow apart with my last swing. So what I did was I went forward to the point where I actually saw my hammer just make that bit of contact, and in the upper right, I just hit the camera icon, and that takes a snapshot of whatever's on screen. I just saved that snapshot to a file location where I could find it, and then I opened up a photo editing software. In this case, I'm using Affinity Photo, but you could do this with Photoshop or anything that works with layers. I went and found that image and brought it into my photo editing software. Now here's where the fun begins. I'm going to duplicate this layer so I have more than one. Now using my selection brush tool, I just let it find the edges and snap to them and sort of traced out an area where the glass line seemed to be in one corner of that image. If you can see here, it's now lassoed and it's got this area selected. I'm going to turn off the duplicated track so I'm only looking at one, and I'm going to invert this selection so that everything other than that spot in the corner is now selected. I'm going to delete everything else, and that now gives me one little corner piece that's down here that sort of follows that shattered glass line. Now in the duplicated track above that, I still have the entire image. Let me turn off the bottom layer and enable the top layer. For this one, I want to invert the selection one more time and remove that bottom piece that I've got isolated in the first track. So now you can see I have one layer that has all the rest and the lowest corner layer that has just that bottom corner. Together, they make a whole picture. Now in this top layer, I'm going to duplicate that again and basically just do the same thing. I'll deselect and start again. Let me choose an area up here with the Smart Select tool. I'm going to invert the selection, and I'm going to turn off the top layer so I just see the second layer. And let me erase everything else that's going on in there, so I've now created my second piece. Let me turn on the top layer, and I'm going to invert the selection one more time so that the opposite area is now selected. Let me select that top layer and delete that. And now you can see I have three sections, a bottom corner, a second corner layer, and what's left of the rest of the image. Let me just duplicate that again, and I'm gonna complete this process just based on how many pieces I think I should have. Once I have the right amount of pieces that I want, all I did was I turned on each individual track, deselected everything that was left, and then just exported each piece one at a time. Now I knew exactly where I had captured that image. So right at that point, I brought each one of these pieces into Movavi as separate images. I brought each image down into its own separate track, right on top of my main footage where that image broke apart. And when each one is turned on, it gives me the illusion of having one complete image when it's actually many separate pieces. From here, all I did was I just added keyframing on each track and moved each piece from where it was centered off to another location using Movavi's keyframing feature. Let me show you how to do that if you've never used Movavi's keyframing features before. Let me just right click in the timeline and add an extra track, and I'll bring one of the pieces down into the track at that point. Now I have this corner. By left-clicking on it in the upper left and clicking on the drop-down video editing menu and then clicking on animation, in the advanced tab, I can click add animation and it'll drop two keyframes on there automatically. Let me grab the first one and drag it all the way back. And then when I get to the second keyframe, let me double left-click on that and you'll see that it highlights in the upper left. I'm going to grab that frame by left-clicking in the preview window and moving that piece to another spot. I can even rotate it a little bit at the same time and have it move away. Now you'll see as this clip plays, that one piece moves out from where it was located to off screen. And if you want to have that happen more quickly, just drag that keyframe closer to the beginning and you'll see that that action speeds up. Do that to each piece and send them in different directions, add a little sound effect on top and a little glass splatter, and boom, you've created the perfect glass shattering effect. If you have any questions about how to pull this off, feel free to leave me a comment down below. But if you want to learn more editing tips, tricks, and techniques in Movavi, click the video that's on screen now or the one that I'll link underneath. Peace. Or pieces.